Dear friend, I do not like high school. I keep quiet most of the time. Some people look at me strange in the hallways because I do not decorate my locker. It's been very lonely recently because my sister's busy being the oldest and my brother's off at Penn State on a football scholarship. I'll keep working hard so I can get an academic scholarship. So that's what I'll be doing until I meet a friend here. Love always, Charlie. Recently, the media has begun focusing on cases of bullying in high school and the desperation it can lead to. Some cases have gone so far as to result in suicide or long-term mental anguish. No doubt, high school's a tough place to fit in, and maybe all you need is a friend. A real friend. Someone who sticks up for you. Someone who accepts you for who you are. The Perks of Being a Wallflower by Stephen Chbosky. Dear friend, I have made two friends! I met Sam and her brother Patrick at the beginning of the year. I went alone to a high school football game, and Patrick, who is in my shop class and a very popular senior, talked to me, even though I'm 3 years younger and not popular. Incidentally, Sam, who is also a very popular senior, has brown hair and very, very pretty green eyes. The kind of green that doesn't make a big deal out of itself. Sam is very pretty and nice, and is the first girl I ever want to ask on a date someday when I can drive. I told Sam what I felt, and do you know what she did? She laughed. Not a mean laugh either, a nice warm laugh. She said she thought I was being cute. But then she looked at me and said, "You know you're too young for me, Charlie. You do know that, right? I don't want you to waste your time thinking about me that way. I really hope this doesn't prevent us from being friends. It'd be very nice to have a friend. I would like that even more than a date. Love always, Charlie." Dear friend, there's a party after the last football game of the year at this guy Bob's house. Sam and Patrick invited me, and I said I wanted to go because I've never been to a party before. When we arrived, Sam and Patch went into another room and Bob offered me a brownie. I took the brownie and I took a bite. And it tasted a little weird. But it was still a brownie, so I still liked it. But this was no ordinary brownie. I think that since you're older, you'll know what kind of brownie it was. Later, when Sam asked me how I felt, all I could say was, light. When everyone was back down at the party, Patrick pointed at me and said to Bob, "He's something, isn't he? He's a wallflower." And when I asked Patrick what he meant, he said, "You see things, you keep quiet about them, and you understand." I didn't know people thought things about me. I didn't even know that they looked. Love always, Charlie. Dear friend, it is now Christmas time, and there's another party at Bob's house. I think I thought about Sam's gift from the moment I really saw her. Not met her, saw her, but the first time I really saw her, if you know what I mean. It was an old 45 record that had the Beatles song Something and a note attached to it saying that when I was little, I decided that when I met someone who was as beautiful as the song, I would give it to that person. So I was giving it to Sam. Sam kissed my cheek and whispered in my ear so no one could hear, "I knew she meant it in the friend way, but I didn't care." And after that, I couldn't believe Sam had actually got me a present because I honestly thought the "I love you" was it. She took me into her room and there I was, looking at an old typewriter with a fresh ribbon. So I moved to the typewriter and wrote something. I love you too. And Sam looked at the typewriter, and then she looked at me. Charlie, have you ever kissed a girl? I shook my head and was quiet. And then she said something that I won't forget, ever. I know I told you that we can't be together like that. And I know I told you not to think of me that way. But I want to forget all that for a minute, okay? I want to make sure that the first person who kisses you loves you. And then she kissed me! It was the kind of kiss that you can never tell your friends about out loud, and it was the kind of kiss that made me feel like I was never so happy in my entire life. After the party, we were driving home in Sam's pickup, and Patrick was driving, and he started driving really fast. When we hit the Ford pit tunnel, all the sound got scooped up into a giant vacuum and replaced by a song on a tape player. A beautiful song called Landslide. And when we got out of the tunnel, there it was. Downtown. Lights on buildings and everything that makes you wonder. And Sam started laughing. And Patrick started laughing. And I started laughing. And in that moment, I swear, we were infinite. Love always, Charlie.